are five ways to communicate God's purposes, God's vision purposes. One is slogans. You can use one-liners. In Hindi, one-liners don't work so much. I've noticed, you know, achhe din aayenge, theek hai. Okay. You know, at campaign time, it works. But ongoing, I don't think, you know, hum do, humare do, I don't know, that hasn't worked. With you always, forever. Dilli Police? I don't know. That hasn't worked. Right? Nike ka just do it became Nike, I just did it. Right? So slogans, you need to figure out in your language, does it work? Nepali, does it work? You know, but have a way to keep communicating. Number two, symbols. Symbols are very powerful. Please be careful. In a country like India, symbols can become dangerous. It can become dangerous. Okay, but Hitler knew the power of a symbol. Okay, religions know the power of a symbol. Faiths know power of a symbol. Armies know the power of symbols. Yeah, patriotic people know the power. You see a symbol, you're like, yeah. How does it, you know, symbols are powerful. And one of the greatest symbols we have is the cross. The place of shame has become the place of grace. The thing that was cursed is he who hangs on a tree, has become a thing that it brings us to our knees and in repentance to God. It's become the most dearest thing to us. So apart from the cross, can we have other non-threatening symbols? Yeah, let me give you some examples. I had a friend of mine design in Russia, in Moscow, and we use theirs. We don't use the ones from Saddleback because you don't have to. And so we designed these other ones. And here are symbols so that you understand it's not like religious and you don't have to freak out about it. But so we designed these. What do you think this one is? Fellowship? Membership. You're right. Okay, that's membership. This one? This discipleship. You see what I'm saying? So whenever you and this is working together. Okay, ministry. This is evangelism, preaching about the cross. And this is evangelism. This is evangelism. This is worship. Something like that. Okay. So you get it's not like intense. It's not like swastika and all that. It's just. You know, so number one, slogans. Number two, use symbols. Number three, scriptures. Teach the scriptures. Teach key scriptures. Okay, apart from the Great Commission and Great Suggestion, teach scriptures. Number four, tell stories. Or stories is an S word for testimonies. Tell stories. Have a discipleship story. Oh, this one I was doing, he's become so mature because I had this what I did. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. So you tell a discipleship, tell an evangelism story. In the worship ministry, in the bulletin, on YouTube, church's YouTube, whatever. Tell stories. Keep telling stories. But stories based on purpose. Evangelism story. A worship story. You keep on pushing it so that through that you're pushing the purposes. And lastly, specifics. People love numbers. Write down specifics and share that. Okay?